time we are going to start with this poem on killing a tree. Okay, so as we have already done this poem on killing a tree, right? So what this poem it actually depicts, that what it is not a simple, you can say, jab of a knife or a cut on the bark of a tree that will ultimately kill it. Okay, there needs to be strong efforts. It has to be completely ripped out. It has completely to be taken out of the earth in order to be killed. Okay, so from this you can say by killing a tree, what does the poet want to symbolize? Actually, how he has related this killing of a tree with life, how he has related this killing of tree with that of life? Raise up your hands. You remember anything? Online ones? Yes, Dia.
That one's job or cut or
saying like na killing a tree. What he want actually to tell? I mean, why this killing of a tree?
To ironically tell that not to kill a tree.
That not?
Not to kill a tree.
Not to kill a tree. Yes, ironically one, this is one meaning. Ironically this is one meaning that the poet wants to tell, that ironically he is telling us not to kill a tree. Okay, because trees are of course responsible for our sustenance on this earth, and it is just because of these trees that we are able to live on this earth. And moreover, he has also related this tree with our habits. For example, some wrong habits are there. Okay, so they have made a deep anchor with our mind, with our heart, and it is not easy to take out those habits out of our life. It is not so easy to take those habits out of our life. So ultimately, what we have to do, we have to, you can say, work upon them regularly. Okay, again and again, that you can say killing must be required in order to take those bad habits out of our life. So symbolically, he wants to tell us this. Okay, so this is means double meaning this poem is carrying. Okay, that on one side, what it is telling us, that ironically not to kill trees. Okay, because trees are responsible for our stability on earth. It is just because of these trees that we are being able to sustain on this earth. But on the other side, watch, he is also relating these trees to that of our habits. Okay, wrong habits, because these wrong habits, they are deep seated in our heart and our mind, and it is of course not possible for us to come out of these habits, or it is not easy to take these habits out of our life. Okay, so when he is talking about on killing a tree, in the very start of this poem, right, what the poet has done, the poet is ultimately personifying tree. Okay, he is personifying the tree. Okay, because he has personified tree as a human being. Okay, he is trying to give human like qualities. And see, you and I have discussed in detail very much at that time why it is pertained to as a human being. Okay, why he is comparing it, all these aspects I am taking in this revision part also, right? So first of all, let us go through the simple explanation of the poem. Okay, first stanza or first passage is, it takes much time to kill a tree. Yes, poet is saying that it is of course not a very easy task to kill a tree. And what it takes a lot of time. Okay, it takes or it consumes a lot of time to kill a tree, because killing a tree is not an easy process. Okay, it's not an easy process. If we think that we will cut down a tree and kill it, no, it is not at all possible. It is not at all possible. What does killing require? Killing requires a much long, hardworking, as well as consistent, persistent activity. Okay? Not a single jab of the knife will do it. So see here, not a single jab. See here. Not a single jab of knife, of the knife, will do it. Now see here. So this line, this line is ending here, and this idea is carried forward here in the next line in order to complete its meaning. And at the end of the night, see, there is no punctuation mark. No punctuation mark is there. No comma, no full stop, but idea is carried forward to next line. According to your book, I am reading it according to your book. So this is what this is in enjambment. So which poetic device it is? Enjambment. So you got what is enjambment? Got enjambment? Vatsal got? Other students also, what is enjambment means? It is a figure of speech in which you can note down. Note down side by side. What is enjambment? It is a figure of speech in which one line of poetry, okay, reads on to the next line. Where one line of poetry, it is a figure of speech in which one line of poetry reads on to the next without any pause. Without any pause marked by a comma or full stop. Paused by any comma or full stop. It means that when there is no comma or full stop or any punctuation mark at the end of that line, and this line is carried forward onto the next line. Okay, this line is carried forward onto the next line. Then what is it? This is an example of enjambment. What is this? This is an example of enjambment. Okay? Got now? It has grown slowly, consuming the earth. Okay, so how it grows? How the tree grows? It grows slowly, consuming the earth. Means slowly and gradually, by taking nourishment from the soil, this tree, it grows. Or if this plant, it grows into a complete tree. Okay, so here when he is saying slowly consuming the earth and then rising out of it. Rising out of me, it means coming out of what? It here refers to soil, earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust. Feeding upon its crust means earth's surface, which contains actually nutrients. It feeds on earth's crust containing nutrients, absorbing years of sunlight, air and water. And what happened over the years? This process of absorption takes place. How this process of absorption takes place? That it absorbs what? It absorbs air, sunlight and water. So see here, when we are reading those lines, slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air and water. So when we are reading these lines, don't you feel that an image is formulated in our mind side by side? When we are reading, we are imagining that a tree is coming out of the soil. It is absorbing air, water, sunlight, and then it is growing further. An image is formed in our mind. So this poetic device, which is used by a poet here, is imagery. Okay. So which poetic device it is? This is imagery. Note down these poetic devices side by side, please. So which poetic device it is? It is imagery. Okay. So what happened that slowly it consumes the earth, absorbing what? Years of, means it take years to absorb air, water, sunlight, so that the tree will be grown completely from the earth crust. And see here that use of enjambment, rising out of it, then feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of air, water. Okay, so ideas are carried forward onto next lines. This is again what? These are again examples of enjambment. What are these? These are again examples of what? These are again examples of enjambment. These are again examples of enjambment. And out of its leprous height. So what this leprous hide means? Leprous hide. Okay, this leprous hide, first of all, what it is a metaphor. What is this? This is metaphor. What is metaphor, Patsal? What is metaphor? What is metaphor? Yes. Which poetic device? Very simple. Which poetic device it is? What is metaphor? Yes. Sarthak. I was thinking that you people must be knowing because it is one of the simple ones. But now by this time, I will telling you definitions of all. So, okay. Metaphor is a poetic device in which, note down, poetic device in which comparison is made, in which comparison is made without use of words like or as. Now see here, I told you that comparison is made here in case of leprous hide. I said comparison is made, but is it use of word like or as? Like this. Okay, sun is shining like a hot ball of fire. So here I'm comparing sun to that of hot ball of fire. Okay, what I'm doing? That I'm comparing sun to that of hot ball of fire. But in this hot ball of fire, I'm using the word like. I said, na, sun is shining like a hot ball of fire. So what it means that when I'm making comparison, I'm using the word like. He's as beautiful as his mom. Comparison is made between the girl as well as her mom. But I'm using word as. But when these like or as words are not used, these are what? These are called as metaphors. What are these? These are called as metaphors. What are these called as? These are called as metaphors. Okay, now got? So this leprous hide, I said comparison is made. With what it is compared to? Yes, compared to. Okay, so yes. You can speak online. I'm unmuting you and don't mute yourselves again. Yes. So what it is compared to?
It is compared to the skin of person who is suffering from leprosy.
Yes. It is compared to that of.
Your voice is not coming.
Now it's fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, right. Some connections get loose. Okay, so what it is there that it is compared, okay, the bark of a tree. Okay, what this bark of a tree is compared to? This bark of a tree, it is compared to that of skin of a man who is suffering from leprosy. Comparison is made, but like or as words ko nahi na use hue. So then what is this? This is what? Metaphor. This is metaphor. Okay. So now why? Why this bark of a tree is compared to that of leprosy? Sprouting leaves. Iske saath hi hai, right? So what it means? It means that the bark of the tree is uneven. It is quite uneven. Okay, you know, you have seen the bark of the tree, you will see that how uneven, similar to that of skin of a man suffering from leprosy. And out of it, what will happen? Those leaves will emerge out. okay, life will emerge out. What now? Fine, that's fine. So in this paragraph, what the poet is telling us, what is the name of the poet? Jay Patel. Okay, Jay Patel. Name of poets are also very important. Jay Patel is the name of poet. Right? So now the poet is telling us that it is not a simple process to kill a tree. Why it is not a simple process to kill a tree? Because this process of killing a tree involves not only a simple cut on the bark of the tree. Because if you will put a cut or if you will make a cut on the bark of the tree, out of that leprosite, new leaves will sprout, new leaves will emerge, and slowly what will happen, this cut part of the tree, it will consume, or it will, you can say, it will feed upon the nutrients of the soil, which are present on the surface of the soil, and absorbing sunlight, air and water, what will happen, that it will grow into a complete tree. Clear this first passage? I'm going so slow. Okay, because I know that during that time, because one or the other reason, you people must not have listened. Right? So any doubt in this one? Okay. First, which are the poetic devices used? Metaphor, enjambment, and tree is personified as human being throughout. Clear now? Now, coming up to next para. So hack and chop. Hack and chop, what is? Hack and chop means again cutting processes. Hack means cutting, cut roughly. Chop means cut with some instrument. So hack and chop, but this alone won't do it. Okay, so again here, see. Again here in this case. So hack and chop. This alone won't do it. This alone won't do it. See here, after this no comma, no full stop. Idea of this line is carried forward to the next line. Which poetic device?
Enjambment.
Again, this is enjambment. Okay, this is an example of enjambment. Okay, so what happened that? So hack and chop, if we will put a hack or chop the bark of the tree, this again won't help to make the tree die. This alone would not help to make the tree go out of life. And enjambment is used. Not so much of pain will do it. Not so much means if you will cause any pain to tree by cutting, hacking, chopping, or attacking with an axe, no. All these things will not help to bring an end to life of tree. Okay? And bleeding bark will heal. Bleeding bark. So here in case of bleeding bark, first of all, there is predominance of this sound B consonant. This is an example of alliteration. Moreover, again, this is metaphor. What is metaphor? Comparison without words, like or as. So here what this bleeding bark is compared to? This bleeding bark is compared to that of what? Yes, Ramni. What it is compared to? It is compared to that of? Yes, I have unmuted you, Ramni. What it is compared to? It is compared to that of blood of human beings. Then what it is compared to? It is compared to blood of human beings. Okay. So it means both the poetic devices are used. And from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs. And from where that hack or chop is provided to the bark of the tree, from the very base, what will happen? New curls of leaves, new leaves, new small branches in the form of curls, they will emerge out. And miniature boughs. Miniature means very small clusters of leaves. they will formulate, which if unchecked will expand again, which means which again if unchecked, if we will not keep a check over their growth, we will not again cut them, they will again emerge out and formulate a complete tree. And to former size means when we are talking about two things, okay, the earlier one is former and after one is latter, and what it will form, it will grow to its old size of which we have cut down the tree. Clear now? So again here, miniature boss, which if unchecked will expand again to former size. What it is? This is again an example of, this is again an example of what? This is again an example of entrapment. Okay, right? So what the poet is trying to explain through, you can say, these two passages, that are, you can say, incapability to cut a tree. Okay, because if we will provide a mild cut, or if we will cut a tree, what will happen? It will again emerge out in its complete size. Okay, then we need to keep a check again and again on the growth of tree. Only then it will be cut. Okay, otherwise what will happen? It will consume, it will take its nourishment, and ultimately what will happen, that it will never be put to death. Okay, so later on in the later part of this poem, we will discuss that how the poet is relating this to our habits, and moreover what he wants to deliver us through this poem. Okay, so now what we have learned from this, yes Purvi, can you tell me what you have learned out of these two paras?
Yes, ma'am, that we should not kill a tree, and killing of a tree is compared to a human, killing of a human.
It's like killing a human also.
And ma'am, it's not an easy task to kill a tree.
It's of course not an easy task to kill a tree. So tomorrow we will continue further with this, you can say, poem. Until now, let me take your attendance also. Okay.